Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. In our today's video, we will simulate the stripper, or can be called as the reboil absorber, using the Aspen Hysis. Stripper is one of the key components or key separation equipment in various chemical processes, and obviously its simulation was pending from my side, so I am preparing this video and covering this topic on my channel. But before starting this video, we need to understand what is the difference between the stripper, absorber, distillation column. So for this, I have presented the four diagrams over here. Now you can see the first diagram is of the distillation column. The second diagram is for the refluxed absorber. The third diagram is for the reboiled absorber or stripper. And the fourth diagram is of absorber. Now in this diagram, you can see both condenser and reboiler are present. And we say its design specification is two, because one is for reboiler and one is for condenser. In reflexed absorber, only the condenser is present, so the design specification is one, or we can simply say it as the rectifying section, which is coming from this part. If you go here, it is a reboiled absorber in which the reboiler is present, while there is no condenser in the system. It is the reboiled absorber or stripping section, which is represented here, or you can say it is below the feed tray area. Once we talk about the distillation column. And in absorber, no reboiler, no condenser. So obviously its design specification is zero. So we are going to simulate the reboiled absorber today. And for this, we have chosen an example. And in this example, with the feed specifications, the temperature is 25 degrees centigrade. The pressure of the feed is 3 bar. The flow rate of the feed is 100 kg mole per hour, and the composition include 50 mole percent benzene and 50 mole percent toluene. So a mixture of benzene and toluene needs to be separated using a stripper. And in the stripper, as I have told you, that the reboiler is present, so the degree of freedom will be 1. It means we have to specify the 1 variable or 1 design spec in the column, which is column component fraction. And in this column component fraction, we have to make sure that in the bottom product or in the liquid product, the toluene mole fraction or the component fraction is 0.999, or that means that we need 99.9% pure toluene from the bottom of this column. We are assuming no pressure drop in the column, and the number of stages for this column are 20. So let's quickly go to the Aspen Hysis and simulate this process. But before going to the Aspen Hysis, if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel, click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. So coming to the Aspen Hysis interface, first we will add our required components, which are benzene and toluene. Then going to the fluid package, and we will add the property package of SRK, which is Soap, Redlich, Wong. After specifying the component list and fluid package, we will go to the simulation environment, and in this model palette, we will go to the separator, and this is the reboiled absorber which is present over here. This is the refluxed absorber, this is absorber, and this is distillation column. So we will click on it and we will paste it over here. After pasting it, we will double click on it, and we will specify the connections. Obviously, it requires top stage inlet, then overhead vapor outlet, reboiler energy stream, and bottom liquid outlet. The top product is in vapor form because there is no condenser present. So we will specify top stage inlet as feed, overhead vapor outlet as vapor, bottom liquid outlet as liquid, and reboiler energy stream as R energy. And there are 20 number of stages, so we will change it to 20, and we can change the column name as stripper or reboiled absorber. Click on this next. We will go ahead through this reboiler configuration, which is by default selected. There is no pressure drop in the system, and the feed pressure is 3 bar, so we will specify top pressure as 3 bar and reboiler pressure as 3 bar. Going to the next, there are no temperature estimates given to us. So we will go to the next. We are not provided with the boil-up ratio. Instead, we are provided with the mole purity. So we will go to the design spec to specify it. Click on this done. And now we have to specify first the feed specification. So going to this worksheet, The temperature of the feed is 25 degrees centigrade. The pressure is 3 bar. The molar flow rate is 100 kg mole per hour with the mole fraction of benzene and toluene as 0.5:0.5. Click on this OK and you can see the feed is specified. Now we have to go to this design specification, and in this monitor, obviously there are three options available: overhead product rate, bottoms product rate, boiler ratio, and currently this option it is, which is overhead product rate. So we will uncheck it, and now the degree of freedom is 1. We have been given that the toluene mole fraction in the bottom product should be 99.9%. So we will go to this add spec, and in column component fraction, we will first select the target type as stream because we need it in the bottom product. And in the stream, we will specify the liquid because it is a bottom product stream. And we will specify the spec value as 0.999, 99.9% or 0.99 mole fraction. Obviously, that has to be considered that if it was mass fraction, then we have selected the mass fraction for this part. And the component is toluene. So we will click it and then we will close the tab. Now the degree of freedom is 0. System is unconverged. Click on this run button. And now the system is converged. We can go to the worksheet to check. And in compositions, you can see that 99.9 mole percent toluene is obtained from our system, which was the requirement. Obviously, you can see that the top product contains 73.44% benzene and 26.56% toluene. But the requirement was, obviously, for the stripper was for to get 99.9 mole percent toluene. If you go to the performance tab, you can check the performance of the system. You can see the column profiles for each stage, the temperature profile, pressure profile, the liquid flow rate profile, the vapor flow rate profile, and the flux ratio and the boil-up ratio for this system. Similarly, if you want to go to the plots, you can see the graph, and the graph is very much similar to that of the conventional distillation, that the temperature at the bottom of the system would be higher than as compared to top system. Similarly, if you want to define the internals, you can come here and you can click on this auto section or add new to specify the column internals, and I have already explained a lot about it in our previous videos. So that's how you simulate the stripper or reboiled absorber in Aspen Hisis. If you have any queries, feedback, suggestion, please provide it in the comment box and I would be happy to answer it. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.